Welcome to the Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 26 in our series, Getting Started with Rails 7. And this is going to be a bug fix video. So in episode number 24, where we did some rich text things, I made some mistakes in terms of the rich text fixtures, and also I took away too much in terms of validation. So we're going to correct those errors in this episode. So the first thing I did wrong was in the fixtures here, the name attribute of each of these should be the name of the field that it's associated with. So right on all these have name, content, and then the rich text body there. So in all of these cases, it's going to be, instead of name content, it's going to be name body that we need, because that's the name of the attribute. So replace those, see if that does anything to our existing tests. It does not, but now if we go in, I'll throw in a debugger statement here in articles test. Should have ran test all before I okay. So article dot body, we actually have an action text content associated with that. This is the plain text. That's the tricks HTML. And then we'll continue here. All right, we did produce one error. Modal dialog, that might just be fixable by not stopping everything. Yeah, we're still not getting that modal dialog in destroying a comment now. 21 and 22. This is one of the ones that we might have changed. Element not found, so that didn't fix it. We'll return that, and then unable to find modal is our problem now. Thank you. debugger here. Comments.last. Body. So we've got let's see if I can pause and find this. All right, so let's see if we can find head over to the JavaScript console. Inspect here. Comments. Destroy comment. Data method delete. It's not continuing when I do that, but all right, let me take out the debugger statement and see where things are. So that all passed. We've only changed our fixture so far. So the thing we want to do now is go back to our model article test and restore back in the validation tests we had deleted out previously. So let's go here we go. This whole section here should be able to paste back in, and they're going to fail because we took the validations out, but title blank. Okay, so we'll go back to normal Rails test here. So we've got two failures, expected true to be nil or false in both cases. So now we're going to go back into our article model. We're going to do validates body presence true. That should change our failure, hopefully. We've got a new failure. We've got a new div.error. So we had before, when we changed this, we went from, we go back up to the articles controller test, that line 173, we had one, we want three back. So articles controller test, back to three div errors here. So now we've got, expecting three, we've got two. And that's two controller tests there. And then we're still failing on test should be invalid if body is too short is our only model test we have left. So the way we're going to do this is we're going to write a validate here, use the class method, and it's going to be body minimum length. This will be a private method. Plaintext.length less than 10, errors.add body and we'll see if we can just get away with short. Down to one failure now. Should be invalid if body is too short. Let's see if I can pass that a hash. That did not work. All right, let's take a look at the Rails validation guide here. Pause for a second and find the spot. All right, so I might just need to here, we will and then we'll use that variable here. See if that works for us. got four errors. Expected. Expected one or two, so I've got the wrong type of argument for errors add. Let me take a look again at the errors section here. So this looks like the syntax I need. I need message here. Back to fully passing our tests. I'm going to, so right now, and the way the Rails guide did this, we didn't do any validations about the comment body at all. So similar to what we did before, we're going to do a visible, like we did with the visible concerns. We're going to do the same thing with rich text body, we'll call it. So we're going to take, create a new concern. Think about the name here. Yeah, I mean, it's not in the same form here, but we should still be able to. Rich text body extends active support concern. We'll make actually our We'll have a minimum body length here. Make that 10. And then from article here, move that. We don't need. I guess I could have just overwritten all of this. Minimum length we've got, and then we want I messed up visible. We don't say visible, so included do, we're gonna have these two validates statements. I don't really need to put spaces between those. And then our private method here. got. And then I just need to change. Oh. Call it min. Make that 10. Get rid of that from the method here, include it in our article, actually include it in our article, rerun the tests. That's working. And then we're going to do the same thing for our comment. Might break some stuff because we haven't been testing against validating it. Nope, still passes. Do a test all here. Nope, that's working. Now we're not actually doing these tests on comment, even though nothing broke. We want to do something similar to what we did in our visible test helper. Helpers will have a new file. I think I might need to include that. So now we'll have active support concern here. And we'll have a shared body setup. And then included block. At our article test. So these are the ones we added back in. right now this is going to only work on article if it works at all. If I include it. See where that gets us for articles. We've got errors. Article.rb. Everything errored out. Let me comment that out. That still failed. Line 11. I copied into the wrong place. There we go. Probably should have just done normal Rails test instead of test all. Run one more time. All right, so that's working. And now if I go and try to include this in comment test, it's going to fail because we're too tightly coupled to article. So all this stuff is related to article stuff. And we can see get new comment, get new article. Run into some issues. So when we did the visible test helpers, bring these back, we had a status existing, status new. Which we already have in both of these, so I should be able to replace article status new. These will all be status existing, I believe. Status existing, and then get rid of that line. Where does that get us? two failures, both in comment test, to include nil. So body can't be blank, body's too short. We have not now, we go to our comment model. My guess is we have not yet. No, we have. Included that. Let me go back to comment test. So line 12 and line 25 are where I'm failing right now. Still line 12 and line 25. Just the comment test here. Models, comment test. All right. Status new. Status new dot valid. Status new dot errors. Is too short. Minimum is 10 characters. Errors. Body blank and body short have not been defined in shared body setup. So I had them in article test and did not move them to the concern. All shared body setup now in both of these. Continue, get the debugger statement. Out. Back to passing. Let's run them all. more time. There we go. We are passing. Now let's test this in the browser to make sure. So we will fire up the server. Take our articles. Body is too short. Edit. Do our update. So looks like it's trying to add the message in there, but I don't see it. Specs. Div field with errors. Label for body. Oh, it's putting it under instead of on top. So it's there, it's just not pretty. I would, if I were to iterate on this user design, I would put it, make it red and probably put it under the body label rather than under the body attribute, the body text field there. So that's working, it's just not pretty. So good there. Now we should be able to run into issues now. Try to do short here. Unable to serialize a comment without an ID. So that is a tricky little item there, so we need our comment controller. Would be initialize and then if save. And that might be why they didn't put validations in the getting started guide. Let me see if initialize is not going to, I just do new. Yeah, New should work. Make sure that it's got the, does have the article ID, so that's what we want. Save, else, so this is what we have. I wonder if I can do render form. Missing template. So that's not working. Let me see if I can do if I can render articles show there. Seems to have worked. We did not add in any error attributes, I don't think, on that form. Comment form here. Well, leave it ugly for now, in keeping with how the form does it. So that's in a div. Paragraph. So it would still be in that paragraph, we would say. Comments, comment here. Same thing for, did I do anything for status? I did not. While we're at it, we might as well require a commenter. This again. Comment. All comment. We'll just say comment. Doing or equals there. To go back into the controller and to do that. Okay, so now that comment. Somebody So I think I actually, instead of putting it there, I'd want to put it in article show. Form article try it one more time, we hope. Yay, now we've got our error. Okay. So now we go in, we'll get ourselves to parity with comment and article here. Commenter, go down to our test, adapt this. All right, so we've got this adapted. We need a commenter blank. Equals. Thank you. link. Run our tests. That's passing. Test all. Modal dialogs being a bit finicky. It did work. Look at all the changes we've made here. So comment controller we changed to account for the fact that it could be messed up and invalid. We added the include rich text body to article and to comment, validating the commenter exists, adding the comment instance variable there, which will sometimes be nil, and so, and when there's an error situation, it will be populated. The comment here, we did the Rails or equals there, so if it's if it's falsy, then it will build that comment. If it's truthy, then it will just stick with the one that was already assigned. Add in the error messages to the item there. We restored our div errors. We fixed our rich text fixtures to make sure that our we're talking about the right field there. There's no content field on comment or article, and that's why our rich text fixtures weren't working in video 24. We factored out the body blank and body short into a shared setup item that is used by both comment and article. We added a test about the commenter, not title. Make sure you, when you copy and paste, you change your names of your tests. And then we created the new test helper, required it. We'll add here, and then write our commit message. All right, so we've got our commit message here. Save it. We will close here. Push to the remote. And we'll see you in the next video.
Want to create your own Ruby gem but don't know where to start? Code along with me on the end-to-end journey of the Nerd Dice project. We'll configure and publish the gem, use GitHub Actions to trigger builds and tests, and create magic methods with Ruby metaprogramming that can roll any number of dice, all while using a test-driven approach. Go to statelesscode.com/nerddicegem to level up.
Thanks for watching this Stateless Code video. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. Check out our growing library of videos on our social media channels, follow us at Stateless Code, and taxation is theft.